What's going on YouTube? Clover Bells here, back with another Series 12 video, and today we're showcasing that dual weather team that we made for the month of August. And again, this is more or less the same weather team that we did a couple of months ago, but you know, again, with August here and World Championships approaching, I did want to end Series 12 by showcasing some of my favorite and strongest teams. We did already Solgaleo with Entei, Tornadus, Kyogre. And then we did a bunch of stuff there, and then of course we've integrated our Series 13 team building videos. But now, again, we gotta finish off Series 12 with a bunch of teams that we made. So here's the Kyogre. It's Water Spot, Origin Pulse, Ice Beam, and again, it is a Mystic Water set. So, you know, this kind of Kyogre is just meant to outspeed Regieleki on their Tailwind and deal a bunch of damage, with the Mystic Water. From here, we have the Tornadus, and this is a Life Orb Tornadus, one of my favorite kinds of Tornadus. Again, you know, if we suspect that they're going for the Fake Out onto the Tornadus, we can just, you know, bait that and Dynamax it. Oh, that's in my way. We can just Dynamax the Tornadus, and then just go for a Life Orb hard-hitting Airstream, boost the Kyogre next to it. And then you'll get speed controlled that way. And then we also have Heat Wave, which is also really good into the Sun matchups. You know, if they bring out the Sun, then we all of a sudden have a stronger Life Orb Heat Wave. So that's very much appreciated, I should say. And then over here we have this second restricted. It's just a Zacian, you know, nothing too special or crazy, right? It's only the strongest restricted in the format. So relatively standard set with the Zacian. Again, the two stabs along with Sacred Sword, and then of course Protect. And then we have Incineroar, because Incineroar just does Incineroar things in VGC. You have Intimidate, Fake Out Pressure, along with Parting Shot for positioning and, you know, weakening opposing mons, and then Throat Chop for that dark coverage against stuff like, you know, Lunala or Calyrex Shadow Rider. And then from here, we have the Venusaur. So again, something that gets enabled by the Tornadus because of Tailwind. And this is our Cobra Berry Venusaur. So at least we can take one Airstream and lift the tail to tail. And then, you know, again, G-Max Mind Lash is a very nice move. Chip damage over time, and then you get Max Quake. And of course, Sleep Powder just for certain outs in certain games, right? And along with the Venusaur, we have the Torkoal. And this is one of my favorite Torkoal sets. And with the Citrus Berry, we have the Burning Jealousy. So if we suspect that there is a Landorus, going for Airstream, or something going for Max Steel Sparks or Max Quakes, for example, we can always click Burning Jealousy and then burn both opposing mods, or maybe even just one. And then, you know, that if they're physical, that's good news for us. If we have the Body Press to be able to click onto something like an Incineroar, that's also really nice. And then Yawn, just for, you know, punishing early Dynamaxes that, you know, just don't expect the Yawn pressure, right? So Venusaur can, you know, get double speed boost in this sense, right? You have the Tailwind, and then you have the ability to swap in the Torkoal, become even more faster if you ever need to. Usually it comes in handy against like opposing Tailwind teams, so you get extra speed there. That's the team. So again, dual weather is always a really fun archetype to play, no matter what series you got. We showcased it a couple months ago, and now we're going to showcase it again. So without wasting any further time, let's just go straight into the ranked battles. Oh man, okay, Zacian Groudon with Thundurus and the Grim Sound. Okay, so Thundurus plus Prankster user. All right, how do I want to deal with this? Torkoal looks pretty cool here, I'm not gonna lie. Torkoal does look pretty cool. I mean, he can always fake out, right? We can punish that. Ogre also looks interesting, say the least. Do I need Zacian here? I guess I could use it, right? There's a Groudon, there's a Grimmsnarl. Do I need Venusaur here? I don't know if I do. I think Ogre is the best play here. I know there's a Thundurus. It's tricky. I know I bring three of the mons, but do I want the Venusaur? This is a tough call here. Landorus would have been nice. Okay. If it is Grimmsnarl. Alright, let's do it like this. Bring you guys in the back. Torkoal. Alright, we're gonna leave the dog behind here. I think that's a mistake, but we will figure it out. Let's see. got a cool team. It all depends on their lead here and how we play it. Okay, I can't read any of that. Okay, Grimmsnarl and Groudon. All right, I was afraid of the Grimmsnarl. But this is also where, you know, Heat Wave can come in handy, right? And we always have Sleep Powder sub, but we don't have to click Sleep Powder, right? There is Incin in the back. Could also be interesting. I think we definitely do Dynamax here, though. And we go for the Vine Lash play. It could Thunder Wave me, that could be interesting. But I think all the more reason to just... Honestly, I'm just going to click Heat Wave here. I don't think I need to Tailwind. My Venusaur is relatively fast now. So let's see what they do here. With the Groudon switch. Yeah, he has to switch. This should be Incin, right? I would imagine it's Incin. Yep. Alright, so good bait into the Vine Lash. I mean, Vine Lash plus Heat Wave is still pretty okay. And now let's see if this Grimmsnarl has Fake Out, or if it's just a simple Light Screen. Alright, good job on the switch. Alright, we do have Ogre in the back later on, which is going to be important when we have to click Tailwind plus Water Spout button. And he's going to preserve his max, so I would assume that... I would assume if it's Incin and then Zacian, right? So there's the Light Screen, so it's Grimmsnarl, Incin, Groudon, and I would assume it's Zacian. Okay. Okay, chip damage. Alright. And there is a Heat Wave, and now he knows that I can be Life Orb. Alright, can I get some burns on the Grimmsnarl? That would be nice. Alright, Vine Lash chip ticking away. And what we can also do is pressure with Max Quake. Alright, so that's always a thing, and I could even protect on my Tornadus here. I think I will go for a Quake this time. He probably could live, but again, I'm just going to click Protect on this slot. Just so that I don't have to take any unnecessary damage. The Incin will probably live. We might activate a Shulker Berry here, but that's okay. Alright, will the Incin come back out here with a Parting Shot or a Fake Out? We'll see. It's hard for him to switch into Groudon or Zacian here, right? Because he just saw that I have Heat Wave. So, have at it. See, he's thinking about it, right? He's taking his time. So here's our Protect. Bing! Alright, did he click the Fake Out button? Oh, he tricked? Oh, Jesus, what is this? Is it Iron Ball? It is Iron Ball. Took my Cobra Berry. Alright, well, here's a Max... Oh, no! Shuka, is this enough to kill? Oh, wow. Don't tell me click Parting Shot. Oh my god, that's disappointing, man. It lived on one. Oh, come on. 1 HP? Alright. Venusaur, you forgot to take your vitamins today. Alright, what is this? Their own Venusaur. Alright, more Vine Lash chip. Okay. Well, we can always just blow this away with, like, you know, I think I can get up the Tailwind now, if anything. He did click the Iron Ball. Give me the Iron Ball. But I can always Tailwind now, but we'll see how he wants to play this. Or if he even wants to max the Venusaur here. He could Sleep Powder me. It would not be great. It absolutely would not be great. And this could be a Sash Venusaur also. Alright. It's got something... I'm just... Did the Incin really live on 1 HP? It happens. Alright, he's taking a lot of... Oh, alright, he's maxing. Okay. He is, in fact, maxing. Now, one would... think you would might want to try and get rid of the Tornadus. Wow, if I didn't click Protect, if I just click Heat Wave, this Incin is dead. Maybe even the Grimmsnarl too, you never know. But now we're in this position. Alright, so here's the Tailwind, and now let's see How fast is this other Venusaur here? And it is a Reflect coming out, so getting ready for the endgame potential. I didn't bring Zacian, so... There is a Flare. Alright, I don't know if that kills. We do have a Spedef boost, so that's nice. Alright, we'll respond with our own Max Flare. Alright. Alright. Now, are they policy? Is the next question. Alright, yes. Yes, the patented weakness policy. But Vine Lash is ticking away. Alright, now how do we want to do this? How many turns of Vine Lash? I do need to get rid of this Grimmsnarl. Last turn of Vine Lash, okay. This is also very tricky. I have to get rid of this thing. Like, there's just no way around it. And I will, in fact, also click Heat Wave. This thing is plus two now. What do we got? Kyogre's gonna come in soon. And we're gonna have the speed advantage and the damage advantage. Alright, so he's withdrawing the Grimmsnarl. Is it Incin or Zacian or Groudon? Oh, I would love to heat wave that. Alright, there's the heat wave. I would love a burn. Alright. There is a Max Flare. That's going into the Venusaur. Okay. We do go down. Okay, however. However, Groudon takes the last chip of Vine Lash. Does have one more turn of max. I could even go into... Do I want to go into Ogre? Do I just want to click Tailwind Water Spout? I mean, oh no, I have a better idea. I have a better idea. So we'll change the weather on him. And now Tornadus has Hurricane Pressure. We can probably just take out that Venu, if anything. Okay. Alright, so honestly, we just click this. And what's he gonna do? Not a whole lot. We click the Hurricane button. What does he do? Swap into Incin? Try and change the weather again? Would be nice, right? Still got all four Mons, but everything's been chipped. You know, from the Incin to the Grimmsnarl to the... Oh, so it's... Ah, okay, so we didn't bring Zacian. Yeah, everything's been chipped. Something's gotta give. We gotta take some KOs here. So he's thinking about it again. Is he gonna guard? How does that help him? Because now his Venusaur is slower. And our Kyogre is faster. Yeah, he's kinda stuck here. He's gotta swap. He's gotta give me the Incin. Oh, okay, I'll take the Grimmsnarl. He does guard. Smart play. Alright, so... we'll take the Grimmsnarl, I guess. And then he'll probably go into Groudon to try and change the weather again, right? Alright, but that's his last turn to max. And again... the light screen is gone. So, we've got potential here. Venusaur is fast again. So that's another thing. We're going to have to go into Torkoal. He's going to bring out Groudon again. He has to, right? We knew he would try and switch it. Now, do you want Incin or do you want Groudon is the next question. Alright, what is this? It's Groudon again. Okay. Alright, so Venusaur is fast again. Alright. And now I have to think... how I want to play this. Alright, so what we can do is switch out the Ogre for Torkoal. We're gonna play the Weather War here. And we will... Does he go for the Sleep Powder on the Tornadus? That is the question. How many turns of Tailwind do I have? This is my last turn. Okay. See, it's... Their Venu versus like my Kyogre. I think he's a timid Venu, right? So that's the other thing. I think I want to at least get rid of that Venusaur. So what we'll do... Oh, wait. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Alright, we're going to Heat Wave. I wanted to protect. I ran out of time. I pressed the B button too much. That might cost me because he has to go for sleep powder here. Oh, we just hit. Oh, okay, never mind. No sleep powder. Alright, Vina goes down. Really nice. And what does Groudon do? If Groudon clicks P-Blaze, that's okay with me. I'll give up the Torkoal, that's fine. Rock Slide, okay. That's a good play. Alright. Tornadus goes down. It's Incin and Groudon versus Torkoal and our Ogre, and we should be the faster Kyogre. And now the weather control is completely on our side. We just protect and we do whatever we want. Alright, there is the Incin. Yeah, it's at 1 HP. It should have been dead. but it is not. So there's the Intimidate. That's okay. I don't think Groudon can actually kill the Torkoal. Yeah, I think we're fine. Unless he's like... We can just double protect here if anything. We don't have to risk nothing. Protect. Protect. And we should be okay. So, bing! There's the protect on the Ogre. There's a protect on the Torkoal. And let's see what he wanted to do. There had to be a fake out going somewhere. And he went into the Kyogre, okay. And this is just Rock Slide. Yeah, that's his best play. But now we just click the Water Spout button and we're fine. And the Reflect is gone. Not that it matters. We just click this Body Press here. And Water Spout and GG's. I don't think he outspeeds me. Yep, that's all we gotta do. Our opponent was top 1,000, so I mean, not top 1,000, top 800, so not bad. Not bad at all. Oh, man. Do I know this person? I think I do. I'm not sure, actually. Okay. So, ooh, Solgaleo Kyogre with Tornadus. Oh, I love it. I love it. And then there's Incin Rillaboom and then an Urshifu. Okay, Venusaur looks really good here. Same with Tornadus. I'm thinking like, if he procs the policy, if I can get a burn off, that would be nice, but I don't think I'm going to be able to do it. How can I stop the Torn on the Solgaleo? Do I have to do Incin? I think I might have to. It's tough. I could just go my own Torn and then just outspeed him, but his Solgaleo is probably like fast. Wow. Okay. How do I want to do this? Do I want to try and fake out their Torn? I think I should. Alright, we'll do it like this. Ogre in the back. And I think we're gonna bring the dog this time. I have no idea if this is correct, but we're gonna do our best. We're gonna do our best. Alright, alright. Johnny Tsunami. In this case, Joey Tsunami. Alright, what are we doing? Tornadus Solgaleo. Yeah, I figured as much. Should have brought Incin. Alright, we got problems. We have problems. Because he's faster, right? Eesh. Okay. Okay. Thing is, if he clicks Tailwind, he's not clicking Brutal Swing. If he clicks Brutal Swing, we got other ideas. I think I might have to Airstream. How do I want to do this? I think I just have to do it like this. Right, Vinelash. Get some chip on you. I don't like it. And then just Tailwind. Oh my god. Don't tell me you're switching into Kyogre. Wow. Okay. Alright, I guess he wants to give that up and then get in Solgaleo next turn and then Brutal Swing and then do it like that. Wow, okay. Yeah, I mean... You can do that. That is fine. Okay, here we go. Max Venu. See, the thing is, I did not bring Torkoal. I did not bring Torkoal. So I can't actually get Max Flare off here. Alright, I do get to take an Ogre though. Alright. I'll take a free Ogre. Okay, I don't think I take a free Ogre anymore. Okay. Alright, there's a Hurricane. Ooh! I'll proc my Copa Berry. Okay. It's fine by me. Alright, now what we can do is honestly just, you know, get rid of the Torn here. Alright, yeah, I think we have to do it like that then. You know, the Ogre will go down eventually. It's just how we want to do it. I guess we have to go with Max Strike here. And then just go into the Hurricane, I guess. And get rid of it. Because we don't want Solgaleo getting Weakness Fossy proc. So there's the Ogre again. Oh, he's procing the Fossy this way. Oh, it's Urshifu, what? Oh wow, okay, a lot of pivoting. Alright, there's the Tailwind. Alright. Alright, here's a free Hurricane. Life Orb Hurricane, might I add. Oh wow, that was... Is that a crit? Or is just Life Orb Torn that good? Alright, this is a Max Geyser in the rain. Okay, it doesn't get Urshifu to Sash, but it does go down anyway because of the Vine Lash. So it's just Kyogre and Solgaleo. Wow, okay, man. Yikes. Alright. And here's the Kyogre again. That's gonna die to Vine Lash. I think we just have to worry about chipping the Solgaleo. And it, to my understanding, there is Tailwind on his side of the field, and there's also Vine Lash chip. Okay, he could have the other move. Who did I bring? I brought my own Ogre, correct? I did bring my own Ogre. Okay, how many turns of Tailwind do I have? I have 2 turns, okay. That's fine by me. Honestly, we can just get rid of that Kyogre right here, right now. We have the control here. I'm just gonna Quake it. I'll Quake it, and we'll just Hurricane anyway. Oh wait, I'm gonna proc the pause. Wait, I forgot. I go. Wait. Tornadus goes first. Oh no. I'm gonna proc the policy anyway. Oh, this is a big mistake. I think I just threw. I thought my Venu was faster. Oopsie. Please protect. Oh boy. Live. Uh oh. Alright, we got a crit. I needed the crit on the Solgaleo. Be faster. Be faster. Oh, he just quaked. Okay, okay. So the problem here is we are gonna proc a policy. This is not what I wanted. Not what I wanted at all. But he doesn't have the speed control for a while, eventually. Okay, we're in trouble now. Alright, now we gotta think. There's the policy. However, we still have the speed on him. We do have the speed, and he's taken by that ship. So is this really bad? Zacian can just clean him up in the endgame. We just have to get him to that point. Alright. Wait, what's this? What happened? Did it freeze? What happened? Hello? Huh? Oh! Why? Alright, I guess? Sure? Alright, we got the clickbait. Dual weather makes players rage quit. Alright, I'll take it. Oh! Jesus. Oh, okay. All right. I know what you want. You want coaching plays with Ho-Oh. And you want coaching into Landris. You want coaching into Dragon Ball. You want coaching everywhere. And there is Weingard. We know that. And there is Snarl, too. So Ogre is going to have its problems here. However, this could be a good game for Torkoal, right? Especially because we can click Burning Jealousy if he does go for those boosts, right? So I do like that idea. Yeah, you know what? How about this? Venue Torkoal, Tornadus in the back, and then Kyuri to wrap things up. I like it. I might be hard reading it too much, but I like it. Yeah, we'll definitely give it a shot here. Alright, what do we got? And it's Zamazenta. Oh Jesus. That's a Mon. That is a Mon. I would love coaching. And I would love to Burning Jealousy everything. Alright, so what we can do is we can sleep out of the Dragapult and then just burn everything. So I'm gonna try that. We're gonna sleep you and then we're just gonna Burning Jealousy this. I could even yawn if I want. But I think this is also fine, especially if he wants to do coaching. I don't know if my Torkoal lives anything. We do miss the Sleep Powder. Does Snarl. Good play. Dragon Dance. Go for the Dragon Dance. Dragon Darts. Okay. Okay. Smart play, not the Dynamax. Alright, so he knows. And it's Life Orb Dragon Ball. Ooh, okay, okay. Alright, I am gonna jealousy that. And we do get to burn the Zamazenta for what it's worth. I guess I could yawn the Dragapult too. It is Life Orb after all, right? Yeah, Life Orb Dragapult's not good. I don't think I want a Dynamax, honestly. Not the Venio. I'm just gonna keep on sleep powdering. I'm just gonna sleep this. And I'm just gonna. I could even yawn it. I could even body press. I'm a just Burning Jealousy. I mean, what else am I supposed to do? Oh, he protects. Ooh, okay. This might be a Behemoth Bash into the Venu then. Alright, so he's got an offensive Dragapult. Okay. I like offensive Dragapult. Here's the coaching. Alright, it's becoming very bulky. That's fine. Alright, here's another Burning Jealousy play though. Alright, enjoy. And we're slowly chipping this Zamazenta here. Okay. Now, once again, I'm pinning the slot. I mean, either way, you know, the other thing we can do is we can yawn it. Because, like, realistically, do we need to yawn? Because, like, what does he do? He can click Airsheen, he can Wurmwind also. So, you know what? I'm gonna just do this just for, like, safety concerns. Just in case he wants to. Oh, we miss again. Uh-oh. Alright, Behemoth Bash. Alright, he might even take out two. Oh, yeah, he's gonna darts. It's been a while since I've missed two Sleep Powders. I'll be perfectly honest. I did not die. That's because it's burned. Alright, there's the darts. I think I live this. I want to say I live. Torkoal lives, and we're gonna activate our Bebri. And we do get the yawn off on the Dragapult. So that's always nice. Again, we're not committing the max here. We're not committing the max. And the Life Orb chip is taking its toll, and there is the yawn. And now what we can do is we can just protect next turn. I'm gonna think here. I can get in Tornadus now. What does he have? Ho-Oh and Zamas. Ho-Oh's kinda like, eh. Alright. I can go into Tornadus and just click. Oh, well, no, I can't technically click that. I can just click Protect. Yeah, you know what? We'll see. I think I will click Protect. Alright. I could even click Heat Wave. could be a slower set. So his... How do I want to do this? I don't have to do it like this. I think I'm still gonna like... I could even click body press into you and just try and get off the Zamazenta. Because what's he gonna do? I have an idea. He's probably gonna switch it and then just like coach that other slot. Realistically, right? Yeah, it's gonna be Ho-Oh and then he's gonna coach it. Yep. He's gonna coach it. 100% gonna coach it. That's why I went for this way. There's the Snarl. Alright, but we went for the body of press. Oh, he went into the... He... Never mind. I still get off the body press. Does that... Is that enough, though? Oh, it is not. Okay, very interesting. Okay. Listen. Now what I can do is click Heat Wave, get rid of the Ho-Oh, but I'm just going to click Tailwind now. And that's all I really need to do. And then I can just yawn this slot, if anything. Or if he wants to coach, he can do that too. Yeah, because even if he kills the Torkoal, I get a free swap into Kyogre over here. So here's the Tailwind. Preparing for the worst. There's the coaching. We did yawn that slot. Okay. Brave bird. Alright, goodbye, Tornadus. It was nice knowing you. Oh, he went into the Torkoal. Okay. He went into the Torkoal. Alright. See, here's the thing. I think you just die to the burn, right? Which means there's no... Oh, it just barely lives. Are you kidding me? He's gonna wide guard. He's definitely gonna wide guard. Oh man, but that doesn't matter because we can just hurricane it. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna... That thing dies anyway. How do I want to play this? He's gonna click that one. I can't believe he lives on one. Good EVs. I think I guys at the hole no matter what. And honestly, I'm just going to... I can just click Protect for now. And just max the Ogre. Because like... But he can Snarl, right? Ah. That's the problem. He can Snarl. But can he afford to? That's the thing. Can he afford to? Alright, we chipped a lot of things here. I hope this is the right call. I wish I had more time to think, but I did not. Is it gonna be Snarl? Or is it gonna be Wide Guard? What's it gonna be? I think you have to like Wide Guard here, right? Yeah, Torn protects. Come on, show me the Wide Guard. Oh my god, he didn't Wide Guard. Okay. Really? No Wide Guard? Alright. So I could've just Water Spouted. Alright, the Zom goes down, the Ho-Oh goes down, you have Dragapult and something. Alright. You have Dragapult and something. Dragapult's already been chipped quite a bit. And I have Hailstorm. What's the other thing? Is it Landorus? Oh, it's Rillaboom! Okay. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Okay. That thing needs to die. It needs to go. Alright, I got two turns of Tailwind. Dragapult is a problem. But I have to remove the Rillaboom. Okay, he can fake out one, or he can Grassy Glide is not going to kill. Grassy Glide is not going to kill, and he has to max something. I think he maxes the Rillaboom, honestly. So I'm just going to do this. I don't think he can afford to not try it. And do I just want a Hailstorm? Yeah, I think I do. Alright, here we go. Max Rillaboom. And again, I do have Tailwind, so you're gonna lose your Tailwind like that. Yeah, he has to max it. I figured. So I'm glad I clicked Hurricane, and I'm glad I clicked Max Hailstorm into this slot. Alright, this is a Life Orb Hurricane, by the way. So, enjoy this. Oh, that's all the damage I needed. Come on, Kyogre, wrap this up here. I know you're minus one, but you can beat a Rillaboom. Goodbye. Nice. Alright, so that should be okay. Alright, that was a great max. That was a great max, buddy. Alright. Alright, so now we kind of just win. Because we can just Hailstorm again, and the Dragapult can't really do a thing about it. Alright, there's a Dragon Darts. Yeet. It is Life Orb though. It is gonna hurt. Alright, but not enough. Alright. And now we have one turn of Tailwind, right? And he's taking more Life Orb chip, and he's taking Hail chip, right? But he will get a little bit more back with the grassy terrain. Alright. Okay. So now I believe this is my last turn, correct? Yes, it is. So very simply, this is just an easy protect. And then what we can do is just Hailstorm the Dragapult, and that should... Oh, actually, you know what we can do? We can Geyser it, so this way we can get Hurricane Pressure back again next turn. And then this way I don't have to risk missing, and the battle is canceled. That's an easy video. All right. And I believe in our other video, we also like went undefeated. Like when we did this team like 2 months ago, did we lose one? I think we did. I'm not sure. It's been a while, but I've always been relatively successful with this team. It's been a really, really nice team. All right. Thank you for the comment, Shard. All right. Where did we leave off in our ranking at the moment? I think we're still relatively okay here. Yeah, we're top 800 now or something else. Be 600, right? I just want to update this. There we go. Alright, top 600. That's not bad. That's okay. Alright, so now let's just go into the runs code and let's get you guys out of here. And there it is, folks. There is our dual weather team. And honestly, once again, we had a lot of fun piloting it. There's a lot of different modes to the team. Life Orb Tornadus is actually very, very good. We know what the Kyogre can do. Venusaur was actually very, very nice in our video. Torkoal did what it needed to do. I got a couple of turns wrong with the Burning Jealousy body press stuff, but like it was still fine. Torkoal did what it needed to do. Once again, just like in when we used this team like 2 months ago, when I made this team 2 months ago, Zacian never got to see the light of day. Zacian never got to see the light of day. And it's the same thing on this kind of thing. Zacian never got to see the light of day. Ogre, Tornadus, and Venusaur, they did a lot of the heavy lifting, and that's kind of how the team kind of plays. And you know, unless you can get past the speed of Venusaur and Kyogre, it's a wrap unless you have the tools. But yeah, definitely give this one a go while you still can. I mean, yeah, you saw it, we're climbing up the ladder a little bit, although I could really care less about ladder climbing. It doesn't prove anything. But yeah, again, we're still mixing in our series 13 content, so definitely you know, keep watching for that. And you know, hopefully we can get off the format with some rental teams for that as well. But again, I still want to conclude series 12 with a few more of our series 12 squad. So we'll be back in the next video, guys. Until next time, peace out and have a good one.